Well, good evening. It is the 9th of April 2021. And right now I'm on the south bank of Brisbane. And the markets are just down that street there, where those trees are lit up. The Brisbane River is just past those trees there. But I'm walking up toward Vulture Street, South Brisbane right now. It's about 7 p.m. At 21 degrees. This is Grey Street right now, running down that way. Trains going by. So we're walking up Tribune Street. Whether you can hear those bats. All right, here's Merivale Street going down that way. If you keep going down Merivale Street, you'll eventually get to the Brisbane Convention and Exhibition Centre, which is down that way. We'll just walk up here a little way. These old houses along here. So we're just at the top of Merivale Street. Merivale Street runs down that way. We might actually walk across here and head down this other street and then turn left. It's a fairly cool evening. Well, these lights are taking a while. Here we go. Going to walk out on the road there. I'll have to get under this foliage. Much lighting through here, pretty dark. Future walks at night, I might bring myself a decent torch, just in case there's some really dark areas. Let's go to the top of this hill. We might turn left. It's like an old smash repair shop in there. Well, this is Vulture Street, and if we continue going all the way down following that white car, well, over the hill and continue further, we would end up in West End area, Montague Road and Boundary Street in the West End. We did a walk around West End. If you want to check out one of my previous videos, just going back along here, along Vulture Street a little way, because I want to take you further back down the other way. As you can see, there's a lot more to see coming back in the opposite direction. Well, this guy nearly got clipped. I don't know why people have to walk where there's no walk signs. There's a no walk sign there too. I bet he crosses. Yeah, there he goes. Not waiting for the walk signs. Saw a lady just the other day. Or was it yesterday? And looked like she was on drugs or on ice, something like that. She walked out in front of a bus and the bus just clipped her. She rubbed her arm and kept walking. Very lucky. Yeah, there's so many people just walk when they've got a red signal. They just walk on the red signal. As we walk along Vulture Street, going in the opposite direction, as I said, to where I'm walking, is West End, Montague Road, Boundary Street, Hardgrave Street. And we did a walk around West End. I think Boundary Street is perhaps the street with the most eating places in West End. We're going in the opposite direction along Vulture Street. Now, I'm not sure how far we'll go this evening, but this should take us to the Gabba Cricket Ground virtually. Well, we'll to the Gabba Cricket Ground, depending if we're going to walk that far. So we're going to have to go underneath that road to get across. See what's up here. Out of curiosity, oh yeah, this leads up to the footpath. If I went further back the other way, I'd end up at the railway platform. Walking over the rail line now. Can you see those rail lines? Yep. This is Somerville House. We'll do another video around here on Somerville House and we may be able to go through there. There's the Queensland College of Art, tied up with the Griffith University. I remember the Queensland College of Art used to be in the suburb of Seven Hills. I used to go there. I first started with commercial art and then I moved on to applied art. This is still part of the property of Somerville House. Just incredible, isn't it? Look at this. Looks pretty spooky at night. Can you just see it through there? $18.99. We'll just go back down and continue along Vulture Street. Queensland Children's Hospital up there. still 10 seconds to cross. So we're continuing along Vulture Street. Heading toward the Gabba cricket ground. It is the 9th of April, 2021, Friday evening. The Mater Hospital over there. Well, it's getting a bit dark in here. As we continue along Vulture Street, comes someone on a bike. Better make way for him. Hello, everyone. Part of the Mater Hospital there. They're the Hillcrest Apartments up there. Be very expensive staying there. As we continue down Vulture Street, Vulture Street was actually named after the Royal Naval vessel of the same name, Vulture, HMS Vulture. That was back in the 1930s. It was named Vulture Street. Hope you're enjoying this walk on this Friday evening. Thanks for joining me on this walk. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so. I get pretty excited when I see new subscribers, and I value the subscribers I do have. Thank you very much. We need to get more subscribers to keep the channel going. Eventually I want to do live streams, and I need as many subscribers as I can get to be able to do that. That's the M3 that leads toward, if you can see through those rails, that's the M3, leads toward the Riverside Expressway. You can see the city of Brisbane, the CBD of Brisbane. There's turn-offs, you can probably see Turbot Street, a sign saying Turbot Street. You keep going, you eventually turn right into Turbot Street and into the CBD. You can choose to go into the CBD via Margaret Street as well if you like. And of course you can head up to the Sunshine Coast and areas like that by following the signs. A lot of construction going on over there. It's probably got something to do with Brisbane's new underground, the rail network. Yeah. It's a train station for the Gabba, which is sorely needed. That'll be a busy station when the cricket's on. To the Gabba traffic area right now. There's Kangaroo Point through that way. We'll keep heading up there. Off we go. Yeah, that's it, all right. As the sign down there says, a train station for the Gabba. A lot of construction work going on there. Another lady running across the traffic. Wow, that's an interesting church. So all that construction there, part of the Cross River Rail, a lot of it going underground, it's provided a train station here at the Gabba. And people can just get off and walk to the Gabba. I mean, forget trying to park your car around here. You can get some buses. If you want to get a cab, when there's a cricket game on, you'd be lucky to get a cab. You'd be waiting a while. So having that new train station there is fantastic. Here we go. Oh, nearly went over then. A bit of dark shadow over a dip in the footpath. Some Brisbane German Club in there. Well, you can't see too much at night, but that's the Gabba there. It's not lit up very well. You see some of the gates there, gate 4 over there. That big structure up there, that's the Gabba cricket ground. And there's your various entrances. Various gates. So that's the outside of the Gabba cricket ground where you see a lot of cricket matches. This is the place in Brisbane where the big matches, cricket matches are played. In Sydney it's the SCG, Melbourne the MCG, Melbourne Cricket Ground and so on. And the Gabba is ours. So that was my walk down Vulture Street on this Friday night, and the goal was to reach the Gabba cricket ground. I wasn't sure if we'd make it tonight, but we did. I've got a bit of a walk back to where I need to get my car. Just can't get over all that construction for that railway station over there, which is part of the Cross River Rail project. So thank you for coming on this walk with me. Again, I appreciate it. Please subscribe and like and all those things. We'll be doing more walks very, very soon. I actually want to walk along Coronation Drive and past the historic Regatta Hotel on one of the walks. Going back to Coolangatta as well. Do a walk down there. I'll get up to Mooloolaba eventually. I think I've got a request to do Mooloolaba. Well, you can hear those bats. So thank you very much. Have a great day, no matter what time of the day it is. And I will catch you very soon. This is Explorer Man, Jeff, signing off.